See, I think you're running and you're gonna take that boy with you. The way I see you's watching everybody talking in hushes, maybe you're gonna take some others too. A thing you ain't consider.
You get caught or not,
it's gonna be the slaves left behind that's gonna pay the price.
Well, don't act like you care about nobody else. You only care about yourself.
You right.
So what's up, guys?
How you doing, man?
I'm good. I can't get over this style here. I feel like we're
same zone.
Yeah, right. Oh, we got the box cut.
Let's see you.
So guys, this show. Mm-hmm. I'm already hooked. I'm from Georgia. I'm already invested.
You're there.
I'm already
right
there.
Yeah.
Oh, you up? Know about the humidity?
That's
then.
Great.
You're from Louisiana, right? Yeah. Yes, you guys know, brother. Brother. Yeah. But I'm invested. What is going to get viewers invested in this show?
I think just the way we're telling the story, the point of view that we've shifted in this. It's
Absolutely.
Not a story about victims. It's a story about the revolution.
Yep.
And the love and the adventure and the thrill mm-hmm. and everything else, the epicness of it. I always compare it to like The Walking Dead and Game of Thrones because it has so much going on. And
right.
you have this group of people who are going and you don't know if they're going to live or die. You don't know what's going to happen
right.
to each character. And then the grandness of it, the grand scope of it,
mm-hmm.
of Game of Thrones and the fight and the betrayal and the love
yeah.
and the it has all of it. Yeah.
Well, you say Game of Thrones and Walking Dead. Is this going to be one of those shows where you have a favorite character and then they're dead the next
I don't know.
You have to wait and see.
But
stay tuned.
Yeah, it's definitely something that you're going to be on the edge of your seat every episode. You're
yeah.
going to be so, I mean, just like with Walking Dead, you're so invested in these characters and you're going to be so just intrigued by the different choices that they're going to be making throughout the show.
Right.
I mean, each episode brings its own new set of problems and its own new set of issues that are just, I mean, you look at them and you go, how are they going to get through this?
Yeah.
How are they going to conquer this? But
and you're probably going to watch and judge it and say, I would have done this or I would have done
right.
that.
But
you would have probably been wrong.
Yeah. You'd be dead.
Now, there's something about the authenticity of the show.
Yeah.
You're on the plantation in Louisiana. The costumes
yes.
are amazing.
Yeah,
was there ever a moment where you're in character and it got too real for you?
Not for me particularly, but definitely for other characters. There is the whipping scene that
right.
happens, and
yeah.
and it was too much at one point, you know, for the actors to deal with. And so that kind of stuff is very real and very energy consuming, spiritually
yeah.
consuming, emotionally consuming.
Yeah, but we had a really good environment, a
safe.
Really great safe environment. Yeah, for us to work and expand and grow and feel like we're okay and we can come out of this stuff because I mean we're dealing with heavy stuff that I can really bring you to some dark places. So we have to be able to step out of that quick.
What was it like for you, because you're a young man,
yeah.
and going on in the country right now, we have a lot of young people fighting for civil rights. What was it
right.
like for you playing a young slave on this show?
It was definitely, it comes with a lot of responsibility, you know, to the younger generation, you know, being in my last year of my teens, it comes with a lot because it's just, there's so much that I have to display, I have to show that, hey, look, this character, he was going through the worst. He was going through way more than, I mean, you can't even fathom what he's going through.
Right.
He's trying to cling on to the basic necessities of life. He barely is getting anything to eat, barely getting food. I mean, he's running for his life, literally. And we have to understand that this is what we came from. And we have to understand that we have that same determination, that same fight to stand up and promote change and promote a new state of mind in the younger generation. You know, we can't sit back and say, hey, you know, we're good.
Right.
We're all right. We have to stand up and we have to vocalize what we want and what we need.
Do whatever it takes to get her free.
We have to protect her cargo.
This is the toast of the underdogs. Now we doing it our way.
I want to be counted. It's our hands that built this country. Our blood that's running through the heart of it.
Ain't no going back. Not for any of us.
Light them